Welcome to HealthyAyurveda.com. I'm Dr. Mike Dhaliwal, Vedic Sage. Today we'll discuss about the basic management of Vata Dosha. According to the ancient teachings of Ayurveda, there are three doshas called Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Each of these three doshas are present throughout the body. However, depending on the predominance of elements and qualities within the individual, this determines one's basic constitution, being either Vata, Pitta, or Kapha. The concept of Vata originates from the Sanskrit word Vaya, which implies that which moves things. So Vata individuals, being primarily of the air element, in a way, just like the wind, Vatas are always moving. Likewise, due to the air element, Vata types often experience cold, dry, light, and mobile qualities. Due to these qualities, Vata individuals may express imbalances such as dryness, pain, irregular digestion, weight loss, increased anxiety, worry, and insomnia. These imbalances generally originate from the excess of cold, dry, and light qualities. And according to Ayurveda, we balance excess by 1. Removing the cause or source of excess qualities, and 2. Introducing opposing qualities to that which is in excess. For example, the management of Vata is centered around warming to oppose the inherent quality of coldness, moistening to oppose the inherent quality of dry and roughness, and weight promoting or the heavy quality to oppose the quality of lightness. Ayurveda explains an interesting relationship between taste with its corresponding therapeutic value. Generally speaking, sweet, sour, and salty taste will help to reduce Vata dosha. On the contrary, Vata is increased by dry leafy vegetables, legumes, beans, peas, and even from airy snacks such as popcorn can increase Vata dosha. Similarly, excess fasting and irregularity in diet and lifestyle can increase Vata dosha. Therefore, in order to remove the source of excess, one would then want to consider limiting or avoiding such causative factors. So these are just easy and simple examples to demonstrate that which can increase Vata dosha. Likewise, in order to manage Vata dosha, we want to consider that which has opposing qualities, that which is heating, moistening, grounding, and heavy, and that which will tend to be weight promoting. Okay guys, this was just a very basic introduction on the management of Vata dosha. And as we continue discussing these topics, we'll begin discussing these topics in greater detail. But until then, I hope you guys enjoyed, and until next time, be well.